Good morning, Dana Hills. I'm Janelle Abbs.
And I'm Becky Marshburn,
and we will be hosting The Splash. Today, we have a couple wonderful segments for you, including Coming Tech, Jobs, What Is It?, and our favorite, Band Hunters 2. In Coming Tech, recently, there has been an outbreak of iPod theft. So if you guys are interested, here's new additions to technologies that you might get in this segment of Coming Tech.
Hi, I'm Andrew with The Morning Splash, and we're here with Mrs. Williams about iPods. Are iPods really allowed at school?
Hi, good morning. iPods, my favorite subject. As you know, after Christmas and Hanukkah and the gift-giving season, there was an explosion of iPods, probably the most popular gift that students received on campus. And along with cell phones, we continue to allow iPods to be on campus kind of on a trial basis. The direction was that they are not to be used in a classroom, much like a cell phone. Students should not be plugged into their iPod during any instructional time, including tutorial, which are included in our instructional minutes. So we're going to take a look at it. If they are intrusive, if they're disrupting the learning process, if it seems that it's really not working out, then we're going to be looking for a recommendation from the discipline committee and the leadership team of department chairs and the teachers on whether they think it's something that should continue on our campus. So we're kind of taking a look at it right now. Theft has been a problem, as you know, so it may be that iPods, although we're looking at it right now, it may come to the point where we can't allow them on campus officially.
So, Mrs. Williams, what would you do if they're stolen? Like, what's the process?
We have had a problem with theft of iPods, and the assistant principals really handle this, but I know that students are asked to fill out a theft report. If they have any leads, the assistant principals try to investigate. They do turn it over to Deputy Moreno and let him know in case he would be of assistance in helping them to retrieve it. The reality is that they are all very similar in appearance, and it's difficult to identify them. And they are very expensive, and unfortunately we have had cases of theft on campus. We really encourage students not to bring them to campus. I've also emailed the parents and let them know that, you know, certainly our suggestion is that they not be on campus. And again, you know, we're looking at a situation that is taking a lot of time away from the APs investigating, and that may be one of the reasons that we have to say, honestly, it's not something we can allow on campus. So I would encourage students at this point to not have them out in classrooms, and just like a cell phone, they should not be used during instructional time. I like music too.
Dum-dee-da-dee-da. Don't take my roses away.
Informational. I wish I had some money to buy some of that new technology. Speaking of which, don't you owe me 20 bucks?
Yeah, I'm just kind of low on cash right now. I don't really have a job.
Well, I know a great way for you to get a job. Watch this next upcoming segment.
All right, we're here with Wanda Flynn, and we're going to ask her a couple questions about getting a job if you're a student here at Dana Hills. Okay, Wanda, what are the requirements for getting a job if you're a student here at Dana Hills?
Well, actually, one of the first things you do is you would have to get a work permit. And the work permit applications are located right outside the Career Center door. People tend to miss them, but they're right there in a little wall folder. So you pick one of those up, and you would take that on a job interview. And then you actually need a Social Security number. A lot of people don't know that. And you can work at the age of 14 if someone will hire you. So that would be... you know, the work requirements are just that you're ready, willing, and able.
And what is the most a student could work during the week if he or she's attending school?
Well, actually, once you apply for a job and you get one, if you're under 16, you can work after school from the hours of 3 to 7 on a night that's before school. On Saturday, you could work 8 hours a day, and on Sunday, you could work 8 hours. You just can't work past 7 o'clock at night on a night before school. Once you're 16, you can work longer, and that's one of the reasons employers like you when you're 16. They actually, you can work until 10 o'clock on a night before school.
And if a student were to get a job without having a work permit, who would get in trouble in that situation?
Well, actually, the employer could be fined up to $1,000 a day.
You have to renew your work permit after a certain amount of time?
Yes, you do. You have to renew your work permit each year. So if you're working at the same job and a new school year starts, you have to get a new work permit. Or if you change jobs, a work permit is only good for one job.
And if you have poor grades, does that affect your job?
It does. You could be put on probation, and we do review grades every time the grades come out. And if it looks like your work could be interfering with your academic progress, your work permit could be pulled.
All right. Thank you very much. All right. Hello, I'm Bobby Goetz, and I'm here with Marissa, and she plans on getting a job in the near future. And what would that job be?
I'm going to work at RJ's Cafe in Dana Point.
So are you excited about that?
Yeah.
Glad to get that job.
I'm broke.
You want more money to buy stuff?
Yeah.
So Jane Olds, why do you want to work at this bagel shop near the harbor?
Because I like bagels, and I just think it would be a fun environment.
Okay. We're with Andrew Rogers. We're talking about jobs today, and I was wondering, Andrew, where do you work?
Bellinopoli.
And what kind of is that a restaurant?
Yes, it is.
And what kind of restaurant?
It's Italian food.
Okay. And what's your position at Bellinopoli?
I'm a delivery boy.
Ooh, we love those delivery boys. How much are you getting paid an hour?
$6.75.
Yeah, that's what we're all making right now. All right, we're here with Kevin. Kevin, where do you work?
Ocean Ranch Movie Theater.
And how's that for you?
It's all right.
And you like, how much are you getting paid an hour?
Minimum wage.
Okay, and do you get paid every 2 weeks, every week?
2 weeks.
Yeah. All right, so, Ollie, where do you work?
Wind and Sea.
And I've been hearing a lot of rumors that you make very good tips.
Yes.
I mean, what's the average we're making a week? Tips.
With a week, I don't know. Let me just put it this way. Friday night, you make $70.
$70? That's unbelievable. Ollie, that's it.
And for our next segment, what is it? Let's watch.
What is it?
What is it?
What is it?
It's obviously of canine origin.
Yo, man, I think that's Lucas.
Is that my surfboard?
No way, it was totally my skateboard.
Stingy.
Is that a carburetor?
It's a banana!
It's a banana.
We hope that answered your question of, what is it? Wait, Janelle, do you hear that? Wow! It's in its natural environment.
This is a rare specimen.
Shh, be quiet. Crikey. Go around.
Next segment is the Band Hunters.
Hi, I'm Andrew with Band Hunters, and today we have Halfcast, and I'm here with
Dimitri,
Matt,
Melinda.
All right, so how long have you guys been together?
Let's see here. I've been in bands for a while, and then I met this guy over here. So how long have we been together, Maddie?
How long? The beginning of the school year.
Beginning of the school year. That's like.
But that's when you were in your old band, so.
So okay, like
6 months.
Six months.
Yeah.
Okay, 6 months.
So 6 months with Halfcast, right? But you've been in different bands. All right, so what do you play at work?
I play rhythm guitar and lead vocals.
Lead guitar?
And I'm just backup vocals.
That's cool. So what's your message towards your songs, like your lyrics? What do you try to say?
We've actually realized that It seems the more harder the songs are, the more weird and funny the songs are, the more serious the lyrics, and the more softer and serious the songs are, the more funny they are. I don't know why we do it, but we do. Our songs are just whatever.
So is it like thought-provoking, or what is it like?
The other ones are just, it's basically like a half and half. Half is very not serious, and the other is just very thought-provoking, as you said.
Okay, that's cool. All right, so how did you guys come up with your band name?
Well, first off, we were called many things. I think our last band name was Lando Griffin. I don't know how we came up with that. But Half-Cast came above because everybody's got different, like, things they listen to. She loves, like, Slipknot and other things like this. This guy's over here, Metallica and Slayer, and I'm over here with, like, Green Day. So we have a mixture of things, and Half-Cast basically just means a mixture of things. I looked it up in the source.
So we're going to roll with the Buzzler band. When's your upcoming shows?
He knows.
That's May 27th at Hoagie Bar, Michael.
No.
Or, no, skate park.
Yeah.
Skate park first.
Over at Lake Forest.
Lake Forest, you said?
Yeah, there's a skate park there from like 6 to 9, May 27th. Then Hoagie Bar, Michael's, I'm not sure about.
We don't know when it is, but there's a big battle dance going on there.
Where is that located?
It's over at
Newport Beach.
Yeah, and it's if we win, we gotta go to Warped Tour. Woo!
All right, I'm Andrew with Banners, and that's it.
Thanks for joining us on The Splash. I'm Janelle Ives.
And I'm Becky Marshburn.
And remember, hugs, not drugs. Secret out.